Dear students, welcome to this video. Here we will be discussing differentiation of implicit functions. So first of all, let us see what is an implicit function. A function of xy is equal to a is said to be an implicit function if y cannot be expressed directly in terms of x. As for example, suppose you write x cube plus y cube plus 3xy is equal to a square. In this case, y cannot be expressed directly in terms of x. So in this section, we will see differentiation of this type of functions. We'll make it clear with the help of some exercises. So let us start with some exercises. Find derivative of y with respect to x when x square plus y square is equal to 4. So we have to find derivative of y with respect to x. So d dx of x square plus y square is equal to d dx of 4. You know, these two terms will be differentiated separately, so we can write derivative of x square with respect to x plus derivative of y square with respect to y is equal to, this is constant, so its derivative will be 0. As you know, derivative of x square with respect to x will be 2x. Sorry, we have to write here x. Derivative of y square with respect to x. So we can use chain rule here, function of function. First of all, y square will be differentiated with respect to y and into derivative of y with respect to x. I mean, this can be written as derivative of y square with respect to y into derivative of y with respect to x. This is equal to g. Your derivative of y square with respect to y is 2y into dy by dx is equal to 0. We have to find out the value of derivative of y with respect to x, dy by dx. So 2 dy by dx is equal to minus 2x, and therefore dy by dx is equal to minus x by 1. This is the answer. Now let us see next question. If sine y is equal to x sine of a plus y, then so that derivative of y with respect to x is equal to sine square a plus y upon sine of y. So from this given expression, we can write x is equal to sine y upon sine of a plus y. Now, differentiating both sides with respect to y, we can apply quotient rule here. So by quotient rule, we can write denominator into derivative of numerator minus numerator into derivative of denominator upon denominator whole square. So sine square a plus 1. Now let us simplify this expression. This is sine of a plus y. Derivative of sine y with respect to y is cos y minus this is sine y, and we can apply chain rule here, function of function. So differentiating sine a plus y with respect to a plus y and differentiating a plus y with respect to y. So derivative of sine a plus y with respect to a plus y will be cos of a plus y, and derivative of a plus y with respect to y is 1 upon sine square a plus y. Now you see here numerator is in the form of sine a into cos b minus cos a into sine b sine a minus b. So this is equal to sine of a plus y minus y upon sine square a plus y. Here plus y and minus y will be cancelled out. So derivative of x with respect to y is this much. Therefore, derivative of y with respect to x will be sine square a plus y upon sine a. This is the answer. Now let us see next question. Third question. If y root over x square plus 1 is equal to root over x square plus 1 minus x, then show that x square plus 1 dy by dx plus xy plus 1 is equal to 0. Here differentiating this expression with respect to x, we can write d dx of y into root over x square plus 1 is equal to d dx of log of x square plus 1 under root minus x. We will use product rule here. So therefore we can write first function, derivative of second function, derivative of root over x square plus 1 plus second function root over x square plus 1 and d dx of y. And in the right hand side, this is logarithmic function, so we can differentiate by chain rule. So this is equal to 1 by root over x square plus 1 minus x into these two terms will be differentiated separately. So derivative of this much with respect to x square plus 1 first by chain rule. So this is equal to 1 by 2 root over x square plus 1, and derivative of x square plus 1 is with respect to x will be 2x. So 2x, and derivative of x is minus 1. So now differentiating root over x square plus 1 with respect to x, we can write here y 1 by 2 root over x square plus 1 into 2x by chain rule. First differentiating this much with respect to x square plus 1, we get this much, and differentiating x square plus 1 with respect to x, we will get 2x. And next term is root over x square plus 1 dy by dx. This is equal to, you see, the root over x square plus 1 minus x, and here we can simplify it. This is 1 by root x square plus 1 minus x into x minus root x square plus 1 upon root over x square plus 1. So you see here this denominator and this numerator will be cancelled out. We will get minus 1 here after cancellation. this is minus x, this is x minus this much, and here 2 will be cancelled out. So xy upon root over x square plus 1 plus root over x square plus 1 dy by dx. Now adding these two terms, x square plus 1, adding these two terms, then LCM will be root over x square plus 1, and this becomes x square plus 1 dy by dx. This is equal to minus 1. Since this root over x square plus 1 and root over x square plus 1 will be cancelled out. So we are getting here, therefore this is x square plus 1 dy by dx plus xy plus this minus 1 has been transferred to left hand side, plus 1 is equal to 0. This result we got here, so it has been now proved. Now let us see one more question. Next, if y is equal to root x plus 1 by root x, then show that 2x dy by dx plus y is equal to 2 root x. So first of all, let us differentiate this given expression with respect to x. Or before differentiating, we can simplify right hand side here. So this is equal to y is, denominator is root x, and this is x plus 1. So therefore root x into y is equal to x plus 1. Now differentiating with respect to x. So d dx of root x into y is equal to d dx of x plus 1. We can apply product rule here. So first function, derivative of second function plus second function, and derivative of first function. This is equal to where derivative of x is 1 and derivative of 1 is 0. So this is equal to root x dy by dx plus y, derivative of root x is 1 upon 2 root x. This is equal to 1. Now multiplying both sides by 2 root x, we will get here 2x dy by dx plus y is equal to 2 root x. This is the result. Now it has been proved. So these are the questions based on differentiation of implicit functions. So students, please do some more practices, and if you got benefit from this video, please share this video with your friends also, and please subscribe my channel so that I could give you every update in time. Thank you very much.